This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Just happened to be that Morgan Spurlock was in our building. You are out working on pushing a movie. It has nothing to do at all with the fact that you are what is it, the NASCAR prom?
This is like if Jeff Gordon was going to the prom, this is my NASCAR prom outfit.
That's nice.
You know, that's what it is. Yeah, no, the film is called Palm Wonderful Presents, the greatest movie ever sold.
Okay.
And it's a film all about product placement marketing and advertising, and the whole film is paid for and made possible by product placement marketing and advertising.
So in the process, you're talking to all these advertisers and trying to convince them to sponsor your movie.
That's right, to get them to come onto the film that we're actually raising money for, that we're shooting in real time, that you're watching in a theater.
So the idea is, beyond just showing that brands are part of your life, but actually get them to finance the film?
Get them to finance the film, and actually we show the whole process of how does it work. The goal of this whole film is transparency. You're going to see the whole thing take place in this movie. So that's the whole concept, the whole film, start to finish. And I would love for CEG to help make it happen.
Yeah, you know, it's funny because when I first hear it, it is the ultimate respect for an audience.
I don't know how receptive people are going to be to it, though.
Do you have a perspective, or I don't want to use angle because that sort of has a negative connotation,
but
do you sort of know how this is going to play out?
No idea.
How much money did it take to do this?
$1.5 million.
Okay.
I think that you're going to have a hard time meeting with them, but I think it's, you know, certainly worth pursuing a couple really big, obvious brands.
Who knows? Maybe by the time your film comes out, we look like a bunch of blithering idiots.
What do you think the response is going to be?
The responses mostly will be no.
But is the toughest sell because of the film or is the toughest sell because of me?
Both.
Most people will recognize you from Super Size Me, and you certainly had a point to that. What was the impetus for doing this movie?
You know, for me, it was just like the consistent and overwhelming amount of product placement that I would see in films and in movies, you know, TV shows. And I just said, well, what if we kind of pulled back the curtain, show how it works, show the influence that these brands actually have over content, and actually get them to pay for it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so what's the thing that you learned along the way?
What I learned over the course of making this film is we live in a time and a place where nothing is sacred, where if there is a place where someone can sell and market something to you, then they're going to.
We've always heard of the sort of sugary snack manufacturers really hitting that prime after-school TV viewing time.
Yeah.
Now you're saying that it's also inside not just the vending machines, but in other places in the school?
It's in other places in the school. Now they're putting up, there's posters outside of the school. They're selling, you know, they're selling ad space on buses. You know, Channel One, which has been around now for 20 years, which has literally commercials being piped in every morning into classrooms as kids are watching a quote-unquote news broadcast.
Right.
I mean, it's kind of scary what's happening.
And it's so subtle, and you know, you sometimes the storylines in big movies are kind of written around. Obviously, we know that the James Bond car gets
That's
its
right.
own hype and so forth. But
yeah.
that car is now in, you know, almost any TV show. They only use Fords or they only use Nissan.
And it'll start off on that extreme close up of the Ford logo, and then you pull out, and the guy gets out of the car, and he's like, "Whoa, glad we're here. This car handles like a beauty," you know. And it's like suddenly the dialogue is being written by advertisers.
And what was the reaction from the people that you were approaching, because they knew that you kind of had this, you were trying to show this whole process?
Yeah.
Were they a little guarded, saying,
guarded is like an easy way to put it. Like we called every advertising agency to help us, you know, get brands on board this movie, and every advertising agency said no except for one. So only one agency out of all the agencies that exist would help us with this film. We called every product placement company that actually puts the shoes on the actors and the sodas in their hands, mm-hmm. and every product placement company that exists said no. Only two people would even go on camera to do interviews about product placement. And so then we started calling the brands ourselves, and we called nearly 600 companies
wow.
to sponsor this film, of which we got 20. So for me, I think the film is an incredible commentary on the fear of transparency within this industry.
Does it work, ultimately? I mean, does placement on the side of a NASCAR or on your jacket, so to speak, convince people that I should stay at a Hyatt and I should probably fly JetBlue to get there?
And when this interview's over, you might just go get a Palm. You got to look out. You're going to have one right now.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, I think it does have an impact, but it's not an instant impact. It's an impact over time. It's not just one thing. It's 10 things that kind of make that impact happen. And it's constantly feeding into that idea and into that desire, where at some point you'll say, you know what, I will get one. I'm going to have one now. And that's what marketers have learned, that the more they can create a 360-degree, you know, marketing campaign around you, where no matter where you go, you're surrounded by it. So when you get in the elevator, you see it, you pump your gas, you hear about it, you know, you stand in front of the urinal and you read about it. Like, right. There's no private space now.
Right.
And
yeah.
What now, what are you seeing in terms of kind of the online space? There's this sort of huge, it was a Wild West for 10 years, and now we see kind of marketers getting smarter about touching me on Twitter here.
Yeah.
And
It's a, well, what's happening with, on the internet is one of the craziest things and the scariest things that I find, because now they're meta tagging your searches, they're targeting advertising to you. A friend of mine, the editor who cut this film, Tom was looking for a bed for his new apartment. He just moved. And he's like, I need to get a bed. And I was like, come on, they'll deliver them to your house. So I did a search. I said, look, this company will bring it right to you. They'll put it in. I closed out that search. I go to a couple of other websites. All the other websites I go to, suddenly all the sidebars, all the bottom are all about beds. Buy beds, buy linens, buy this. Like, so literally everything's getting fed to every other website that I go to now just based on that search. It's becoming so smart and targeted, but at the same time, incredibly manipulated.
And finally, is there a way to stop it?
There's two things that has to happen. One, it comes down to us. You know, it comes down to a level of awareness of just knowing how much marketing there is. I think that's the first step. And then the second is asking ourselves, where do we draw the line? You know, do we really want to live in a world where everything's brought to us by some sponsor, where everywhere we go, somebody's trying to sell us something? You know, right now there's a bill that they're talking about putting into the city council in New York City where they're going to sell the naming rights to parks and playgrounds. So am I going to be taking my kid to the Bank of America Park to go to the Pepsi Playground to, you know, slide down the Hostess Twinkie slide? Yeah. You know, I personally don't want to do that.
All right. The movie comes out April 22nd. Its name is?
Palm Wonderful Presents, The Greatest Movie Ever Sold.
Morgan Spurlock, thanks for joining us.
Thanks.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari. Stay with us.